الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا للإيمان وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله بعث بالدين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارِك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلِّم تسليمًا كثيرًا أما بعد الله سبحانه وتعالى tells us in سورة الإسراء أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وقضى ربك ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه وبالوالدين إحسانا إما يبلغن عندك الكبر أحدهما أو كلاهما فلا تقل لهما أف ولا تنهرهما وقل لهما قولا كريما. In this ayat in Surah Al-Isra, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ Allah has decreed and written upon you أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ We only worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So لا إله إلا الله, the first thing. And what's the next thing after لا إله إلا الله and worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا سُبْحَانَ اللَّهُ Taking care of the parents and being good to our parents are number two after La ilaha illallah. Qada rabbuka Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed it upon us. The most important things is La ilaha illallah, we worship Allah, and then take care of our parents and be good to our parents. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, Imma yablughanna 'indaka al-kibra ahaduhuma aw kilahuma fala taqul lahum uffin. If they reach become old age, one of them or both of them, فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَ أُفٍّ Do not tell them off. As we said before, the scholars say is, it's the least word of displeasure you can show anybody is to say off. The least. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, don't show your parents any kind of displeasure whatsoever. فَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَ أُفٍّ وَلَا تَرْهَرْهُمَا And don't tell them off or push them aside. وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا And say nice words, kind words to your parents. وَخْفِدْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الظُّلِّ مِنَ الرَّحْمَةِ وَخْفِدْ لَهُمَا جَنَاحَ الظُّلِّ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showing that the bird, the wings are his strengths and that's how he soars. But if we notice a bird that has a broken wing and you see how weak and how, you know, it's trying to weak and showing weakness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, with your parents, اخفض لهم جناح الزل. Put your wings down and show your weakness in front of your parents. واخفض لهم جناح الزل من الرحمة. Why? From mercy. And وقل رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. And say, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them as they have taken care of us while we are young. So always we remember to pray to our parents and say, رَبِّ ارْحَمْهُمَا كَمَا رَبَّيَانِي صَغِيرًا Because why? We remember the weak times when we were weak and they took care of us. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us and forgive them and have mercy on them because they took care of us and they sacrificed for us when we were young and weak. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one of the Sahaba was passing away. And the other Sahaba is trying to tell him, say, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ is dying. And they want his last words to be a shahada. But as they tell him to say it, the words does not come out. So they rushed to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, this Sahaba is dying, but he could not pronounce a shahada, Ya Rasul Allah. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came and asked, does he have a mother? Is his mother still alive? They said, yes, Ya Rasul Allah. He asked, bring her. So they bring the mother. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, how was your son? How was your son? She said, he was a good man, Ya Rasul Allah. He prays and fast and get up at night to pray. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked her again, how was your son? And she knew now what he meant. How did he treat you? And she said, Ya Rasulallah, he preferred his wife over me. He brings her the good food and the good clothes, and he neglects me. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked the Sahaba to go and collect some wood. So she asked, why ya Rasulullah? So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, we will burn him, subhanallah, we will burn him. She said, no ya Rasulullah, don't burn him, I have forgiven him, subhanallah. So we can pray and fast and worship Allah as much as we like, but we have to take care of our parents and we have to be good to our parents, because this is the number two after La ilaha illallah, subhanallah. So Rasul told her, it will be better that we punish him in the dunya than the punishment of a day in the day after, because how he treated. He preferred his wife on his mother, so the prefer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here we see that we have to take care of our parents and put them number one always, because they have put us always as number one, subhanallah. And I was reading a small thing on Facebook yesterday that said, our parents treated us as prince and princesses when we are young, so we should treat them as kings when we are older, and they are older, subhanallah. Think how they sacrificed themselves for us when we were young. So when we get older, we may treat them as kings and queens, subhanallah. This is the relation between the children and the parents. And then Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu tells us, I don't know anything that brings us closer to Allah than birr al-walidin. Nothing brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than being good to al-walidin, good to the parents, and taking care of the parents. And they tell us, being good to the parents will forgive our sins. A man went to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah, I have committed a grave sin. What do I do? So what does the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tell him? Is your mother alive? He said, no, Ya Rasulullah. He said, do you have an aunt? He said, yes. He said, go and be good to her. Allah will forgive you, subhanallah. So if we do bad deeds and we want the forgiveness, we go to our parents or to our aunts or to the close relatives and be good to them. They tell us Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, seen two men walking. So he asked one of them, what's the relation between you? He said, he is my father. He said, okay, you know, the etiquette of treating your father, don't call him by his name. And don't walk in front of him, and don't sit down before he does, subhanallah. Don't call him by his name, don't walk in front of him, and don't sit down before he does. This is Abu Huraira teaching a young man the etiquette of dealing with the parent. And another story where a son, his wife has gotten older, his mother has gotten older, and his wife had asked him to get rid of his mother. She's becoming a burden on them. So he takes her into the woods and leave her. And then comes the wolves, and the mother could hear the wolves. And then he decided he wants just to go back and have a look at his mother. And she sees somebody coming from afar. She tells him, if you see my son, please warn him that there is wolves and I'm worried about him, subhanallah. Only the parents will put us ahead of them. And as we see, Nuh alayhi salam, what does he pray? He says, رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَلِمَنْ دَخَلَ بَيْتِي مُؤْمِنًا. So he asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive himself and his parents and whoever comes in his home as a believer. So we always have to pray for our parents and pray for them. Prophet Musa alayhi salam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I want to see my neighbor in Al-Jannah. He's curious, who is his neighbor in Al-Jannah? Prophet Musa is one of Ulil Azm, one of the top messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and curious, who is his messenger? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him, look at this man walking ahead of you, he is your neighbor in Al-Jannah, subhanallah. So he's curious, what does this man do to become the neighbor of Musa alayhi salam in Al-Jannah? So he follows him. And the man goes into an old shack, and there is an old lady, he takes care of her and feeds her, and then he walks away. So Musa knocks on the door and goes in and asks the old lady, who is this man that came in? She said, it's my son. He comes every day taking care of me, cleaning up and providing me with food and taking care of me. So he asked her, what do you pray for him? What do you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for him? She said, I ask Allah that he becomes the neighbor of Musa ibn Imran in Al-Jannah. He becomes the neighbor of Prophet Musa. He told her, do you know Musa? Do you know him? She said, I don't know him, but I know he's a very good man, and I want my son to be his neighbor in Al-Jannah. This is the dua of the mother for her son, subhanAllah. And then, as we said before, a man was taking care of his father, but his father is getting old and frail and his hand is shaky. So every time he gives him a plate, it falls and breaks down the plate, the china plate, he falls from his hand and breaks down. So he thinks, why not buy him a wooden plate? So this way, when it falls down, it doesn't break. And he takes his son, the grandson, to buy the wooden plate. And then when they buy the wooden plate, the grandson says, what is this for, daddy? He says, it's for your grandfather. He has gotten old and he breaks the plates. This way he will not break the plate. And as we said before, the children are very perceptive. He said, very good, daddy. Because when you grow up, we'll feed you from the same plate. Kama tudina tudan. Whatever you think you'll do now will happen to you. And that's why Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, birru aba'akum, tabarrukum abna'akum. Take care of your parents, your children will take care of you. So the best insurance, if we are worried about what's going to happen to us when we grow up, we take care of our parents. And then our children will take care of us. Very simple equation Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has taught us, birru aba'akum, tabarrukum abna'akum. Take care of your parents, your children will take care of you. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, all the children of Adam commit mistakes, and the best of those who commit mistakes are those who ask for forgiveness. So let's pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and ask for his forgiveness. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. الحسن البصري used to not eat from the same plate as his mother. So when they ask him why, he says, I'm afraid that my hand might go to a piece of food or a piece of meat that my mother was thinking about or looking forward to. So he wouldn't eat with her in the same plate. So she does not put his hand ahead of her and take what she has. And they tell us one of the tabi'een, he was taking lessons, learning lessons, the Quran and the deen and the masjid. And his mother comes calling for him and says, come on son, feed the chicken and take care of the animals. So he leaves. He doesn't tell her, no, I am busy with learning my religion. I am busy with learning the Quran. He leaves to obey his mother, subhanAllah. And then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told the Sahaba, Abu Umar, Umar and Ali, there will be a man coming from Yemen called Uwais ibn Amir. If you see him, ask him to pray for you, subhanAllah. He's telling Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu and Ali ibn Abi Talib, there is a man coming from Yemen. If you see him, ask him to pray for you. So every year in Al-Hajj, they go out to try to find Uwais ibn Amir, this man that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, ask him to pray for you. And then finally, one year they find him, and they ask, what's special about you that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, the Sahaba, to ask him to pray for us. And the one thing is, bir walidatu, he took good care of his mother. He took care of his mother, so his dua become acceptable. And he will do the dua for Umar ibn Khattab and Ali ibn Abi Talib. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will delay the punishment for any sin except uquq al-walidain, being bad to the parents. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it has to happen in the dunya. And that's why they tell us, whatever we tell our parents, our children will tell us and do to us 20, 30, 40 years later, subhanAllah. So we have to be careful how we treat our parents, because it's exactly what we will get from our children, no matter how long the time is. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when the son of Adam passes away, all his deeds are stopped except three things. The first one is عَمَلٌ صَالِحٌ يُنْتَفَعُ بِهِ, good deeds that he does, or صَدَقَةٌ جَارِيَةٌ, a good sadaqah that people continues giving. And subhanAllah, our scholars only tell us today about gift to a masjid. And I am biased because I think they will tell us to give to the masjid because they want to take the money for themselves. As-sadaqah al-gariyah today, as Sheikh al-Ghazali said, we don't need to invest in bricks and stones. We need to invest in our youth to grow up and invest in them to learn. So as-sadaqah al-gariyah maybe is a scholarship for our young people to learn. SubhanAllah, I was discussing with some of my friends, we never go in a hospital and see a wing donated by Muslims, subhanAllah. Sadaqah al-gariyah, we need hospitals, we need schools, we need community centers for our youth to learn. That's the sadaqah al-gariyah. SubhanAllah, if we go to areas like Mississauga or in Lawrence, between every two masjids there is a third masjid. We don't need more masjids in these areas. We need to help build schools and build our young, invest in our young people, because they are our future, inshallah. Sadaqah jariyah. And the last thing is waladun salihun yad'u lah. A child, a good child that prays for him, subhanAllah. So we have to teach our children to pray for us, because that keeps giving. And Rasulullah alayhi wa sallam tells us, a man in the day of judgment seeing himself going up higher and higher in al-jannah, and he asks, why ya Allah, what have I done? They tell him, your son has asked for forgiveness for you. Your son continuous for, prayer for you, that's how high you get. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, tells us, a woman came to him and said, ya Rasulullah, my mother has passed away and she owed some days of fasting. Should I fast for her? He told her, yes, you have to fast for her. And another lady came and said, ya Rasulullah, my mother has promised to do al-hajj and she passed away before she can do al-hajj. Do I have to do it for her? He said, if she owed some money, would you pay it for her? She said, yes, ya Rasulullah. He said, similarly, do the al-hajj on her behalf, because she promised and she could not fulfill. And Rasulullah alayhi wa sallam tells us, the best deeds that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves, first one, as-salah li-waqtiha, to pray on time. And the second one, birr al-walidin, being good to the parents. So after prayers on time, is good to the parents. And then the third one, al-jihad fi sabilillah. So subhanAllah, birr al-walidin is number two and ahead of the jihad fi sabilillah. And the scholars tell us there's three things there is no exceptions for. Birr al-walidin, you be good to the parents, whether they are believers or unbelievers, whether they are Muslims or kafir. There's no exception. We have to be good to the parents, and the only thing, if they ask us not to worship Allah, that's the only time we disobey them. Other than this, we have to be good to them. And the second thing, al-wafa' bil-ahd, fulfill our promise to a Muslim or a non-Muslim. There's no excuse. If we made a promise, we fulfill. And the third thing, ada' al-amana, honesty. To be honest with Muslims and non-Muslims. There's no exception, subhanAllah. Being good to the parents, fulfilling the promise, and the honesty. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if you want to repay your dad, a father, the only way is to buy a slave and free him for the sake of Allah. Nothing else will do it. And as we said before, a man took his mother for al-hajj and carried her. There is no wheelchairs in them times. He carried her on his shoulder for al-tawaf and al-sa'y, everything to do al-hajj. And then he came to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, ya Rasulullah, I carried my mother throughout all the manasik of al-hajj. Have I repaid her? And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you have not paid even one talqa, one compulsion, when she was giving birth to you. Subhanallah. Not one thing, Subhanallah. We can never repay our parents. And this is the example where we said before, a man went to his father and said, you have been a great father and I want to repay you. What could I do for you? He said, just take me one day to the market and do what I ask and you would have repaid me. So he carries his father to the market and the father says, I want some ice cream. He takes a lick of the ice cream and throws it on the floor. I want some food. He takes a bite and throws the sandwich on the floor. And the son is patient because he wants to repay his father. And at the end of the day, the son asks the father, did I repay you? He said, son, I did all this for you when you were young. And I always prayed that you grow stronger and I see you stronger. I know when you were doing all these things for me today, you're thinking, when is he going to pass away? So I am free. Subhanallah, how could you ever repay me? Subhanallah, how could we ever repay the parents? And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا. And then the issue here becomes, what if our parents has passed away? Is there a responsibility for us to our parents? And Rasulullah said, yes. What do we have to do? Al-istighfar lahuma. Always pray for them and do istighfar lahuma. And fulfill whatever they promised. If they promise somebody or they owe some money, we fulfill. Wa ikram sadiqahum. And be kind to their friends. So whoever their friends were, be kind to them. And the last one, Salat al-Rahim, and visit the relatives, subhanAllah. So yes, as the parents pass away, we have a responsibility. And that's why they tell us, Abdullah ibn Umar was riding his ride in Mecca, and then he seen a Bedouin. So he took him and was very generous to him. So some of the Sahaba told him, he's just a Bedouin, he would have accepted anything you do for him, any little thing. He said, he used to be a friend of my father, and my father liked him, so I am doing this to honor my father. So here, subhanAllah, we have to take care of their friends and be generous and visit the relatives. And scholars tell us one of the best things we can do for our parents is always give the charity in their name. We get the sawab and they get the sawab. So whatever we want to do sadaqah, give the sadaqah out of the name of the parents for them to get the sawab and we get the sawab. And then Rasulullah says there's four groups, they will not see al-Jannah. One of them, mudmin al-khamr, somebody who's drunk all the time and who's addicted to alcohol, he doesn't see al-Jannah. And the other one, akil al-riba, he who eats from the interest. And the third one, akil mal al-yateen, he eats the money or takes the money of the orphans. And the last one, al-aqil walidi, somebody who's bad to his parents, he would never see al-Jannah. Subhanallah. So being bad to the parents is equivalent to being drunk all the time and eating the money and taking the money of the orphans. And as we know, Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Sulul was the top munafiq, hypocrite in al-Madinah. And his son came to Rasulullah and said, Ya Rasulullah, this man has harmed you a lot and harmed the believers. Let me kill him to get rid of him. So Rasulullah says, no, take care of him and treat him well. Subhanallah. That's Kibir al-Munafiqeen, the biggest hypocrite. And his son wanted to kill him, so no other Muslim kills him. So he tells him, no, take care of him and be good to him. Subhanallah. And so the best way to be good to our parents is obey them and listen to their orders and be humble with them regardless of how much we learned and regardless of how high we reach, we be humble, subhanAllah, because they sacrificed everything for us, so we be humble to them. Khaftu sawt, and don't talk loudly to them, talk gently to them. and use nice and gentle words and pray for them and read the Quran for them and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always to forgive them. And finally, the last thing we leave you with is the thought, birru aba'akum tibirrukum abna'akum. Take care of your parents, your children will take care of you. The best insurance you can give for your old age and when you get older is take care of your parents now. The children will take care of us when we get older, inshallah. Allahumma ahdina maulana fi man hadayt, wa afina fi man afayt, wa qina wasif anna sharr ma qadayt. Allahumma barik lana fi ma atayt. Rabbana hab lana ma yuqarribuna ilayk. Rabbana wa la taj'al lana fi jam'ina hadha zanban illa ghafartah, ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا هما إلا فرجته، ولا دينا إلا قضيته، ولا حاجة لنا في هذه الدنيا لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا سرتها يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان، ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا. ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم، إن عذابها كان غراما، إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين، واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى، وأنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي، يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم، واستغفروه يغفر لكم، وأقم الصلاة.